With Lucky Land Slots, you can get lucky just about anywhere.
This is your captain speaking. We've got clear runway and the weather's fine, but we're just going to circle up here a while and get lucky. No, no, nothing like that. It's just these cash prizes add up quick. So I suggest you sit back, keep your tray table upright, and start getting lucky.
Play for free at LuckyLandSlots.com. Are you feeling lucky? No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
This is Converse with Us with Chris Donovan and Evelyn Rivas.
Welcome back. Hey, how's it going?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Nice to meet you. My name's Chris.
And my name's Evelyn.
Nice to meet you, Evelyn.
Great to meet you.
You want
to
marry me? Whoa.
Done and
are
done.
Are you a genie? Can you blink your eyes and wiggle your butt?
Whoa.
Or is it nose?
That's, like twerk? Like
I'm talking about like, giving like, dreams and wishes to...
Like, you look like you're going to sneeze.
I do actually feel like I'm going to sneeze now. Welcome to Converse with Us.
Yay. Thanks for being here with us again. We're on a roll.
Yeah. What, like 1 week in a row?
Two weeks in a row. We've got a show out.
You sound like Count
Dracula. Two weeks in a row.
It's actually quite a big feat for us.
The count in Sesame Street.
Yes, and this show, you can go to thisisfunner.com for all other stuff that we do, but this show, we start with food, and right now we're going to start with somebody chimed in on the social media boards.
No, honey, it was more than somebody. It was like 50 people, so which is a monumental number.
It is for me being in the post.
So I had shared on my story on Friday night, I believe it was Friday night, that you were making... one of your specialties, the Chris specialty, the chicken taquitos that you really love making. And you had been planning on making them for a whole week, actually, which was funny. But when we did an Instacart order earlier in the week, they didn't.
That's right.
You want to tell what happened?
Could be user error on either side of the Instacart order, okay. Either me or the shopper. But I think I got one half of a chicken breast or something because it was 0.3 or something. It doesn't make sense.
Okay, yeah. So he wanted pounds. Chicken. He wanted three pounds of chicken. And something happened, and literally the package that came to our
door. It was more paper than chicken.
It was so tiny. It was like smaller than my finger. It was so small.
It was so bad.
And it was like 0.3 of a pound. Not even that, like 0.03 or something. It was a little dumb. It was really funny. But so we couldn't make them earlier in the week like you had planned.
No.
Instead, we waited. We got the chicken a second time. We tried again. And we ended up getting the right chicken and everything. And you made them for us on Friday night, which we were so excited because everybody in this house loves your chicken taquitos.
And now let me elaborate a little bit on them because they're a family staple in my family and extended family.
I got messages from your extended family.
It's the turkey taquito
that
starts it all because it's leftover Christmas or Thanksgiving food.
Yep, and
or,
that's how I had them the first time with you.
And they're so good. I mean, they're so simple. Yeah, it's so good.
Yeah, so, okay, we need to talk about your process because this is a question I got a ton of because I didn't actually show the finished product. I guess I should have done that.
Really fast.
I was just joking around when I was posting because remember I was goofing off on Friday night. I was feeling better, and so we were dancing in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. And
they were forcing me while I was cooking.
I was forcing you. He was in the vibe zone. By the way, the kitchen is the vibe zone.
Yep.
The dance floor and the vibe zone in our house.
Yep.
So if the music's on, you have to be vibing every time you walk in the kitchen. So he's in the kitchen cooking, and I was letting him slide because he wasn't super vibing, but he was making us food, so I was going to let it just go.
Yeah, you were.
he. All I showed really of your process was you had all of the tortillas laid out. You were assembling them, so you had like all the cheese on them, and you had all of the chicken on it, and you had just started rolling them.
I was in conveyor belt.
Yeah, mode. Where you were just like making them all before you put them in.
Cheese, chicken, roll.
Right.
Stack.
Okay, so I got this message. This is one of the funniest ones that we got for sure on Instagram. It's from one of our dance moms. One of the funner ones from Kirsten. She said, okay, I have a question. Those are taquitos, right? Because I always have to stick them with a toothpick.
Hold on. Let me answer the first question. Yes, they're taquitos.
Yes. Okay, there we go. Question number one, done. Nailed. Because I always have to stick them with a toothpick. Can you school me? You want to answer that question?
I could school you.
Okay.
But...
Next question. How does... I thought you wanted me to go question by question.
No, I was going to elaborate a little more on the answer, but I don't think that you'd really need schooling.
No, she doesn't. No, she doesn't. Okay, so how does he get them to stay in the tortilla placed in oil first and then fried? Help, LOL. Last time I made them, I left a toothpick in one and my brother-in-law almost went to the ER.
That would not be good.
No, not good at all. So how do you do it? Because it is kind of magical how you make them and they don't open.
Oh, yes. Well, I mean, I'm just that good. You know that when it comes to breakfast burritos in this house, everybody makes me make their breakfast burrito because I can roll it perfectly.
You are the perfect roller.
I'm a professional burrito roller.
That's for sure.
Or taco or enchilada.
Everything rolled.
But anyway.
That's going to be the name of our restaurant.
I even kicked your ass on tamales that one time,
you
too.
You did. That is jacked up, actually, now that I think about it.
It's a simple process for the most part. But what I think... I don't know what everybody else does, but what I do is I first heat up the grease and then I pre-fry the tortillas just a little bit to like get them a little pliable.
Okay, so that they're
easier,
like
easier to roll without falling apart.
Okay.
So once that's done, I've already cooked the chicken. I usually boil it and then let it sit and then I shred it and then I do whatever seasoning I want. But a lot of people use sour cream and stuff, so it doesn't really matter what seasoning or salsa. So and then I shred the chicken and I put the tortillas out. I put a slice of cheese, which is... probably not the best cheese in the world, but it tastes so good.
That's the second thing I got a lot of comments on.
Sliced cheese.
So is he really using sliced cheese in his chicken taquitos?
Okay. Hell yeah, I am.
And I'm like, look, I can't explain it because I don't really care for sliced cheese and stuff either, but it tastes really good. So either way, however he's doing it, it works. You've used other types of cheese before.
Yes. Yeah,
I've sat there and grated cheese for you for these, but yeah, you use sliced cheese on this. So people were like, well, is that really sliced cheese?
For a couple reasons. One, if you use shredded cheese, it falls out a lot easier.
It does. Yes, that's true.
So the sliced cheese sticks to the tortilla and it doesn't come out. It doesn't fall over or anything. So it melts slower.
And so, so the order would be though.
It'd be you put the tortilla down, put down your half a slice of cheese, your chicken, not a lot, can't do a ton. I learned that. Then you just roll it up.
And I noticed you did a different technique this time.
What'd I do?
You placed all of your items closer to the edge of one side.
I always do that.
I've never seen you do that before. Yeah. I always see you put it in the middle.
No, I always do that. I always put them on the side closest to me because when I start rolling them, I want the chicken and the cheese all ready to be rolled up.
Yeah. No, you did. It was great. And so now what do you do?
I just pick them up and then I just move them over next to the stove. They're just rolled tight enough. They don't unroll. Like I'll have one or two that unroll through the process, but I'll just roll them back up.
For the most part, they all stay.
Yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong.
Do you have to place them in the oil at a certain way?
Yeah, I do. I pick them up with my hand, with the tongs, right in the middle, holding it close.
Clutching it.
So when I set it down, it sets down so the fold is in the grease on the pan, so that is what makes it stay closed.
So it has no choice but to stay closed because it's not.
And then I don't use a very big pan; I use like three or four at a time. So it's
that
a small
is the
pan.
Key, I think, too.
And then that way the pan kind of helps everything stay close. And then once that one side's brown enough and I turn it over, it's holding itself together at that point.
Yeah. So I think it's that's yummy. Also part of the process is you don't do mass production. In that part is a one taquito at a time part, which is hard. That takes a long time.
Yeah, that's and then if you don't have enough oil, you have to put more oil in. And I mean, it's fun. Don't get me wrong, I like doing it. I love the end product. Wait, that's for damn sure.
You totally must love doing it because you make them all the time, and you like making them for us. So
this
is
like my
helpful.
Chicken enchiladas or my taco salad.
Yeah. Yeah.
My go-tos. If I'm going to ever run out of any food, it's not going to be these three.
Yeah, I got enough. Yeah. I know I'll make this work.
I'll adapt it to chicken taco salad. I don't care. I'll make it work.
Look, just give me some tortillas, give me some cheese, and give me some chicken, and we're going to make this work.
I can make fire. but yeah, no, they're very simple, but they're good. What I do after that is I use paste picante, and then I get the Rotello tomato, chunk tomatoes, and then I mix those together, and then I just scoop it into the taquito as if the taquito was a straw eating the tomatoes.
Ew.
I don't know what to put. A sarlacc pit.
Gotcha. Okay.
Eating all the tomatoes. Got it. And then I just bite the head off the sarlacc.
Nice. Oh, that makes perfect sense.
But you use sour cream. Guacamole obviously is really good.
Anything that you would have taquitos with, that's kind of the way I look at it.
And one time, didn't we mess around and I did the all but the last step of the taquito, which we're frying it, making it hard. Had them all rolled up and I threw them in a pan. I put over the chicken enchilada sauce, and then I put cheese on it. Remember when I did that?
I don't remember.
Oh, God, it was so good.
I mean, I bet it tasted pretty similar
now
to.
Now I want that now. Okay, cool. I know we're going to go to the
that,
store and get.
That had to taste pretty similar to the enchiladas.
It
that's
was.
Why.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
yeah. It was so good, yeah. Same ingredients.
No, you do good. I mean, you make some great white versions of Mexican food.
I call it white trash enchiladas.
Okay, well, fair.
White trash taquitos. But
you're
not
allowed
white
to.
Trash taquitos.
You're allowed, not
those
me.
Are just turkey tacos. But then everybody, when I say turkey tacos, they're like, what? And
I know.
I say taquito.
Taquitos. Yeah. I know. It's funny because that's what your family says. Oh, I make turkey tacos. And I was like, those aren't tacos.
Those are taquitos.
I'm like, but it's okay. I know it's weird to say taquito.
Yeah, and also our enchiladas are layered like lasagna.
I know. But it's dude, like, it's so good. It's so good.
It's like we're that kid in college that got to the last step and said, screw it, I'm just eating this.
Yep, it's happening.
I don't have that ingredient, I'm going to use this.
Well, very well done, because it was grub. We had leftovers for Saturday, and they're
Cassie
gone
ate
now.
Them all, that jerk.
Cassie ate them for breakfast.
I know.
That was funny.
I did eat one or two for a late night snack.
Oh, that's why they went so quickly.
Hell yeah.
I didn't get any seconds.
You snooze, you lose.
That's what happens.
Sicky McGee.
I know. All I'm right. Better now, though. Yay!
Yay, you're better?
I'm better.
All right, should we get into Right Now, Right Now, then?
Let's go.
Right now. I'll go first. Plus One Story's out now on thisisfunner.com.
Yay!
There's two episodes out. Well, there's going to be three out this Wednesday. The Wednesday episode that's mm-hmm. coming out this Wednesday, the 11th of January, 2022,
okay.
is a friend of mine mm-hmm. who was at the 1984 filming of Michael Jackson's Pepsi commercial.
Oh, my God.
As Michael Jackson's plus one.
Wow.
Yes. No, wow. It was plus two, but I honestly, it was everybody, Michael Jackson plus everybody.
Yeah.
He got escorted personally by Michael Jackson,
no.
side stage, just far enough out of the way of the cameras, and he saw it all.
And that was the famous Pepsi commercial that
started the barbiturates or whatever it is.
Well, God, I don't know. Yeah.
His drug use for painkillers.
Because mm-hmm. his hair caught on fire.
Yeah. And he says,
oh, my God, what? He was the plus one there.
It was him, Rick Dees, and Michael Jackson.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And he said he remembers it so vividly because they looked at each other, him and Rick, and they were like, what the hell just happened?
Oh, my God.
That's the biggest man in the world. And he even says,
star.
I'm not going to give away the whole thing because a lot of stuff that happens, but at the very end, after it all happened and everything, Michael still gave him a wave to those two.
Aww.
To him and Rick.
Because those were my plus ones.
Yeah, there was other stuff happening that they had other plans, so yeah. I'm sure that played into it. But
okay, I need to hear that episode. That's awesome. That's going to be a classic one.
Oh, my God. It is so great. So check that out. The other one is, there's two up there. One, my friend Travis was on Universal Studios on Mushrooms with his very famous friend.
That's a funny story. I heard that one.
And then the other one was where I took Eric, my buddy, as a plus one to Hollywood. So
oh,
check him out.
Nice. Yeah, you got some good stories so far.
I know. Don't listen to the first one, but you can listen to the second and third one.
I can't listen to the... Oh, really?
No,
oh, really?
Kidding. You can listen to all
of them.
I
heard you record it.
I know. And you know Eric too well.
Way too well.
So,
okay. My right now is, okay, I'm feeling better. It may not sound 100%, but I definitely feel better.
Here, let me lower the low end and higher the high end.
Okay. So get me that sexy sound.
Like, welcome to 94.4 Jazz.
I am back.
Is jazz even a station format anymore?
I think there is jazz stations. Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry, I'm interrupting. Go ahead.
Yeah,
jeez,
I was trying to get my voice on. Okay, so I feel better now. And so because of that, I am going to finally start my New Year's resolution.
You're going to cover the patio?
No, that's what yours is.
Oh, shoot.
Mine is, I've said it the last two episodes, but I haven't been able to do anything with it. I'm going to get my ass walking.
Yeah.
So
whether it be attacked by a dog or snow mm-hmm. or car accident.
Nope, nothing's going to stop me now.
You go, girl.
Like Starship.
What?
That song.
Oh,
nothing's going to stop. Okay, I'm sorry.
That's two song references in this right now.
And they were like, oh.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Yes, I did do that.
I was trying to let Feel Better Now
slide. Yeah, with Post Malone there.
Oh, my God.
Well, those are the two radio stations I work on represented. One's today and one's, you know, best of the 80s, 90s.
Stanley, good job. Tucci.
I am good.
Yeah, you are. I'm, now you get 100%.
Thank you.
Now, what did you say we right now?
So, yeah, I'm going to finally kick my ass into gear.
Okay.
I need to. This
Did you? Oh, that's right. You got second place in our fantasy league.
Was that my ESPN app?
That's why you still get alerts and I don't.
Oh, are you serious?
Probably.
No, well, stop
you,
it.
No, you won second place. It's over.
I did win second place. I should have made that my right now.
She got second place in our fantasy league and I got very last.
Yes. And that and it's really kind of funny because all the wives beat the guys in this fantasy league.
And you weren't good.
I wasn't doing great.
You were medium. I think you were 6-6 or something.
But I was very diligent on dropping and adding players.
And I did the same thing too, but I always had so many hurt people.
Yeah.
Then I drop them and then I go back to pick them back up and some jerk took them.
I know. Yeah, I know. Well, I had Carson. I had Carson and then
I had Wilson.
I know. It was just a mess.
Oh, no, I didn't have Wilson in the league. I didn't have Wilson in the league. No, I had Lamar Jackson who got hurt. Oh,
such a mess. Okay, anyway, I'm going to kick my ass back into gear.
Maybe she's going to start playing football.
I'm going to play football. That'll do two birds, one stone.
The non-fantasy version.
if it's a fantasy, I'm not walking it. I'm telling you right now. Yeah, no, I'm excited. I'm going to finally do that. And I've got to get back on my, you know, like diet stuff and really focusing because it was hard to while you're sick. It is really hard to focus on
anything
that's getting you outside, first and foremost, when you're quarantining. And even though I was like, oh, I can still walk. It's not like I'm going to go run into people. Mm-hmm. I was like, oh, I don't really feel like I have any energy.
Yeah, you still were working.
I was so tired. I was working from home, but I was so tired, like a lot. I still am kind of tired. But
I think a lot of that, on top of you having the Rona, was the fact that, you know, we had a house full of kids still because it was distance learning week.
Yeah,
so no matter what, you would do your work, then we'd start their work, and then I'd get on my work, and it was just like, by
the time we were done, it was like, can we sit down and just not go
so enough complaining and making excuses.
Yeah, nope, I'm on it.
Get on that.
Get down on it. Oh, there's another song. Get down on it. No?
No.
Okay, round two. Name something that's not boring.
A laundry? Ooh, a book club. Computer solitaire, huh?
Ah, oh, sorry. We were looking for Chumba Casino. That's right. Chumbacasino.com has over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.
Okay.
My whole brain is full of song lyrics. You know that, right?
Yeah, mine too, but I can't think of any of them when you say it like that. I can just hear your references and like keep going on it, but then you do another one and then I get stuck on that one.
You're lost.
And I'm already like, you know. Stay.
You're going to sing Lisa Loeb right now?
Isn't that the one that always it's always stuck in your head?
Oh my God. I can sing that song start to finish 100% without looking at lyrics. Yep. I know every single word.
What's the other one? Well, there's one other song. It's like it's another 90s song. It's like, I don't know.
It's Bone and Biggie. No. I'm Being Dangerous. Hey, do a minigame bang with us.
No,
that one?
I know.
I know that one.
We know way more than most people. Savage Garden.
You should see. Oh God, Savage Garden. That don't song. Get me started on Savage Garden.
That song that they sing that will not leave your head.
I hate it. You know why? Because when I worked at Macy's,
Truly Madly Deeply?
Yes, when I worked at Macy's, it would play all of the time, and I was like, no. Stop it. Like, because I would, you know, I was working in women's ready to wear.
Oh, there you
and
go.
They had like a soundtrack, you know, whatever their Muzak thing that was. Oh, that one. Don't do that to me. Don't do that to me. Stop.
Okay, I'll stop.
Just stop.
There's the other one, too. Anyway, okay.
Show me the meaning of being lonely. That was the other one at Macy's. Oh. I always had in my head.
It wasn't.
Show me the meaning of being lonely. And then, like, at the end, it was, tell me why. It was like that close that
tell
was so.
Me why.
And that didn't even bother me.
That was
really.
NSYNC?
No, that's Backstreet
Boys. That's what I thought. I was pulling them up.
But that's actually two Backstreet Boys songs right there, because I was singing one. You started singing
the other,
a different one.
Which one was I singing?
You were still singing, tell me why you ain't nothing but. Okay, that's
that?
A different song.
Oh, shit. Well,
I'm talking about show me the meaning of being
all
lonely.
All boy bands sound the same.
No, they don't.
All right, old kid on the curb.
My goodness.
So we're going to move over into our topic.
Yes.
It's kind of a somber one a little bit, but.
But happy. Yeah, all my memories are happy.
It ties our relationship from the very beginning. Another comedian passed away recently, Bob Saget, a couple days ago, and rest in peace.
I physically cried.
Yeah.
It hit really close to home.
It took me a little while to get to get there after I started seeing all the posts. I mean, everybody I know knew Bob.
Everybody. We knew Bob. We knew Bob. Everybody.
The very first time I ever reached out to Evelyn, you know me, I'm all about work first.
Sure. Sure.
But no, I was working at X. She was working in 991 KGGI, and I emailed her the Jamie Kennedy song, Rolling with Saget.
Yeah.
Because Bob had just left my studio, and he was on the way to your studio.
Yep.
So I emailed it to you, and you're like, oh, thank you so much, because we used it to mess around with him. It was like an intro, like, yeah, here's your Bob Saget.
Yeah, and you could totally get away with that more because you were on a rock station.
Oh, heck yeah.
And he was like, oh, you got to use this, da-da-da-da. And I'm like, oh, okay, thanks for sending me that. That was literally our first correspondence.
Yeah.
And then Chris
ever
and
since
I.
then, we've had three kids, two and a half.
All thanks to comedians. Yeah. I'm just kidding.
So Ralphie May. Bob Saget, Steve Trevino. Jeff Garcia falls in there somewhere.
He's always just
Brad
the
Williams
cracks.
Just there. Mm. We always have to find him.
For sure. Gabriel Iglesias.
Gabe Martin. Man. Ugh.
Way too many.
But yeah,
fun.
We knew Bob. He was the first correspondent between myself and Evelyn, and he came to my station five or six times.
Millions.
GSN.
Yeah.
I mean, I think he was at a party I went with Bob Gowen, not Bob Saget.
Oh.
Or something. I know he was doing something with the improv with Cindy too. So I've met him and worked with him a number of times.
And that was the thing. So the first person I text after you and I were like, oh my God, I text Cindy, who is a good friend of ours. She used to she did PR for the improvs. Yes. And so she's actually the reason you and I met, because she's the one that connected us, was like, you guys are meant to be. I don't know if you guys know this, but you're
exactly
the same person. And I looking back, that's an insult. I'm kidding.
Totally.
For you, it is, for sure.
No.
So she was the first person I thought of, because obviously I knew how much she spent time with him. She spent a lot of time with him. And then she, you know, added to the text. She's like, oh my God, I'm in so much shock. Thank you for telling me. She had been really busy. She's got two little tiny kids now.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
So she didn't even see the news.
I was going to say, we thought she would have known.
I thought so, but I kind of knew. I knew she's been very busy. And and she's completely out of that type of business now, so she's not completely looped in. But she's like, oh my God, he's just the sweetest, kindest guy. And I was like, I know, that's all I ever remember of him. And then she said that, you know, her ex, who was the GM of the improv too, in I think Brea, he was very close with Bob.
Irvine.
Yeah. And so, you know, so many of our circle, our inner circles, knew Bob personally, like knew him as
a friend, a colleague, a coworker, a tour mate.
A text friend. Like, seriously, like they would just, I haven't seen him in so long, but we text message all the time.
Somebody that was a friend, but then he got to write on Fuller House, so he went and talked to him about stuff.
Yes.
So there's all sorts of
different
connections.
Oh, my God, that's so true. Yeah. So,
God, I just got chills.
I know. Okay, so I remember a story, though. The one story that I remember, probably was the last time I talked to him, made me laugh so hard. So he had called my phone. Okay, so he was going to be on the air with us, but he wasn't coming in. He was just doing a phoner.
Okay.
So he was supposed to check in and let me know when they were ready or something like that. So he called the wrong line. Basically, he called my cell phone. He was supposed to call the hotline.
I remember this now.
He was supposed to call the hotline. So he called my phone, and I didn't answer. And so then he called it again. I answered the phone. He goes, so what are you, ditching my calls now?
Yeah.
And I was like, who is this? He's like, it's Bob. And I'm like, oh, hi, Bob. I was like, no, you're supposed to call the other line. This is my cell phone.
You called this at night.
And he's like, I wanted to call your cell phone, Evelyn. And I was like, okay. And so we get off the phone, and he calls the hotline, and he makes this whole bit about trying to get at me. And he's like, I don't know what's going on with me and Evelyn anymore. She doesn't take my phone calls. He's like, and it was so funny. It was just so silly, but it was true to the kind of person he was. He could make any situation make you feel special, first of all. And he understood how to do it. He understood how to be in a moment on the radio. As somebody as a radio personality, that matters a lot.
He knew him well.
He knew. And even if he didn't know you well, he was going to have your name written down somewhere. So he knew how to reference you, how to, you know, look at you when he was talking. He was very charismatic, and he was just so funny. He was just so funny and so, so kind.
I don't remember who we had him call, but we had him call and leave somebody a voicemail.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey, is Bob Saget calling you? Somebody said you like Full House or something like that. And he just went just off went for like off. A minute. Oh, my God. It was so amazing. And he did just, shit like that all the time.
And he just didn't care. He was like, yeah, what do you want me to do? Like, he was just, he loved making people smile. And that, and if he could make someone smile, he was going
to
do it.
Yeah. And what's funny is most people are shocked by who he might really be on stage compared to America's Funniest Videos.
Which I think
House.
Is my favorite part about him.
I know. So once people found that out, they were like, whoa. And then it was like, oh, okay, this is, this, it works.
So, okay, yesterday, you know, you and I were going down the rabbit hole of the Bob Saget yes. stories. And I was like, oh my God, I will never forget. When I was watching Half Baked and in the 90s, and it was the first scene I ever saw of Bob Saget being like blue, you know, even though I had heard he did oh. like adult comedy, right?
You but say I had blue, not it's blue, like dark but, blue.
But remember this. Do you have it?
Yeah, I'm going to pull it up right okay. now.
And I remember being like, oh my God, not my Daddy Tanner. Like, what's he doing talking like that? And it was it's the part in the movie where the main character, Dave Chappelle, goes to rehab for marijuana.
All right, here you go.
Marijuana is not a drug. I used to suck for coke.
Okay, that's what he says. Do you want me to go more?
Well, it's, the whole scene's funny.
Okay, okay.
Like, you ever suck some for marijuana?
No, I can't say I have.
I didn't think so.
Boo this man!
All right, okay, so if your you kids are in the car, I'm sorry. Well, no, you I could beep that.
Yo, bleep that. Make sure that's all bleeped out, please.
Okay, bleep. I gotta do more work.
Oh my God, that was the funniest thing ever. I just remember I was like seeing that going, my Danny Tanner, just say that. Oh my God.
He's so funny.
So funny.
I love the Jamie Kennedy song that I actually sent you that first email because It's
basically true to what he
was. They were just hanging out, partying, going from comedy club to comedy club yeah. after Full House, having a good old time. He was from Scream fame and all this other stuff. He Malibu's, so they were friends.
Yeah, they were buddies. All the comedians knew each other, you know, and if you were a good one and a good person, mm-hmm. you were beloved and you hung out with Bob Saget.
So here's the song that he wrote. He's in the video with him.
Yeah.
In a cardigan sweater.
In a cardigan sweater.
I'm going to play the very end because it's my favorite.
Night, Michelle.
Night, Michelle. Nice. Oh, my God. It's so funny. Oh. There was a story, because I was just watching everybody's tributes yesterday yeah. and today and all that. BJ Novak. Am I saying
yes,
that?
Yes, from The Office.
He was recently on his podcast, mm-hmm. and it was so funny the story he told, which you totally should find in his podcast. But I don't even remember what the name of it is right now. But he said that he was so young and he was coming out to write on his show, and he had to get on the phone with his mom. Like Bob Saget got on the phone with his mother, and convinced that he would take him under his wing and make sure that he was, you know, handled with care, basically, you know what I'm saying? Like, yep. That he would make sure that he was okay. And, you know, when he lived with, you know, them, he would make sure he was never out in the streets doing stuff.
But we'll take care of him. He'll be safe.
But that was the complete opposite yeah. of what Bob Saget did.
BJ say? He goes, no, we were in the club every night partying, drinking. And I remember thinking to myself going, this isn't what you promised my mom.
And then he went on to say, he goes, but you actually did take care of me every time. Yeah. It was never, I was never in danger or anything like that, but
Armchair
it was so
expert.
Funny.
Armchair Expert's the name of the show, I believe. He's got a bunch of them. No, he's got a bunch on here, doesn't he?
Yeah, that's Dax's.
Oh, that's Dax, yeah. Why is it coming up like that?
I don't know.
He was a guest on that show.
Yeah, but BJ has his own podcast.
It's, I don't know the name of it. That's Bob Saget. No, this is BJ Novak on Bob Saget's show.
Well, maybe that's what it was.
Bob Saget's here for you. It's his podcast. It was this last week, yeah.
It was 3rd. Bob Saget's podcast. Yeah. I only saw the clip.
Yeah, Bob Saget's here for you on the All Things Comedy Network.
That's cool.
Bob was a cool guy.
He was a great, great human. And, you know, love to his family.
What was cool about that call to your cell phone? Is I remember, if I remember this correctly, it was kind of around the time that Fuller House was out, season 1 or something, and Cassie knew who he was too. So she was excited.
Oh yeah,
that's Daddy.
And she and there was another season was coming out, mm-hmm. and so she had asked questions about the next season or whatever. Yeah, yeah. And I remember
so that's what was really cool about that is like, oh shit, even Cassie knows him because of this now. You know.
Yeah.
So.
I wonder. Oh,
I
wish I had his voicemail.
I know, like you didn't save it or something.
Well, it was so long. It was a while back. I'm sure I had a different phone and stuff by then. But, that's just like one of those things, you know, you wish you had.
That was a lot easier to do. It's a lot easier to do stuff like that now.
Mm-hmm.
Where back then you'd have to like call from the station.
Yeah.
Turn the Vox Pro on or whatever recording.
It's such a mess now.
I know. So now it's just like, okay, I'll push a button.
Oh, you're calling right into my line.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Good
stories, though.
He's a legend.
Gone
so
way
sad.
Too young.
God, he's way
just young. At the beginning of his new comedy tour.
First weekend.
Yeah. Yeah.
They haven't said why he passed yet, huh?
Mm-mm. They're not saying they don't think it was foul play or any kind of substances and stuff. But
I mean, what if it was something silly? I shouldn't say silly. But what if it's something like he choked on a grape?
Oh, my God.
Like something just...
I don't
absurd.
Know. I will definitely not speculate on any of that.
I was thinking about that. I'm like, what could it have been?
I mean, it could be anything.
Robert Lane Saget. That was his real name.
His had a heart attack, maybe, or something. You know what I mean? It could be just something as simple as, you know, you're alone and you don't have the help to get. I don't want to even speculate. I don't know. I don't want to even think that way. I just rest in peace. I hope he is at peace. I hope he's making God laugh. I know he's doing that. The angels just got a little funnier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, man's got a hell of a catalog of work, and mm-hmm. I have not met one person that said anything bad about him.
That's it. Good person.
Yeah. So, all right. Thank you, Bob, for being in our lives. And
yeah.
I don't think you're going anywhere for a while with all the Full House that's running on TV or
I know
or Entourage.
Makes
or
me
want to
watch
Buddies.
Makes me want to watch it again.
Law and Order, Surviving Suburbia. Ooh, let's watch his roast.
Oh, that's a good one.
Let's
that
go
would
watch
be a
his
fun.
Roast.
That'd be a fun one to watch today.
All right, everyone. Thank you for listening. Go to thisisfunner.com. Check out all those other podcasts and stuff up there. Hit us up, Chris_Donovan on most social media platforms.
Yeah, I'm at Evelyn E. Rivas. You can usually find me. I try to respond to all the messages.
And thank you for listening and rate, review, subscribe, and tell a friend.
Yeah, we'll catch you later.
Converse with us.
Converse with us.
Thank you for listening to Converse with us.
Okay, round two. Name something that's not boring.
A laundry? Ooh, a book club. Computer solitaire, huh?
Ah, oh, sorry. We were looking for Chumba Casino. That's right. Chumbacasino.com has over 100 casino-style games. Join today and play for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. Chumbacasino.com. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply. See website for details.